The credibility of the Sports Illustrated investigation into the Oklahoma football state program is in major jeopardy. I'm Paul Folger. Today, SI released part three of its series detailing alleged drug use among former players. Linebacker Donnell Williams says in the article, quote, drugs were everywhere. But ESPN just released its own article revealing some of the allegations in the SI investigation are completely false. We have team coverage tonight. Let's go to sports director Brian Keating. And Brian, ESPN did some major damage here.
Absolutely. They did do major damage, finding flaws in the testimony given by former OSU player Fada Carter. Among other things in the report, specifically, though, about the former player getting his degree. Now, he told Sports Illustrated he had 2 degrees from Oklahoma State, and ESPN says he didn't even graduate. Now, I talked to the reporter who broke that story tonight, ESPN's Brett McMurphy.
Former Oklahoma State safety, Fada Carter, who was one of the individuals quoted most by Sports Illustrated, some of the aspects of his story were simply not true. Carter and SI reporter George Borman said that he graduated from OSU, but the school's registrar office said he did not.
Is it fair to say that you have serious questions, or at least some questions, about the Sports Illustrated report?
One of their lead sources that has been quoted extensively, we found a couple of instances where he flat out lied.
Strong allegations from ESPN. Brett McMurphy says he has the documentation and the findings to back all that up.
Okay, Brian. Well, now let's turn to KOCO's Morgan Chesky live in Stillwater. And Morgan, one of the players featured in the Sports Illustrated article today was never actually approached by the journalists.
Paul, that's right, and that's why former receiver Bo Bowling really wants to speak out, because he only calls his story half true, saying it detailed his fall from grace, but faulted a program he credits with saving his life. We met Bo Bowling on the field he grew up playing on. As a Tonkawa Buccaneer, a state championship paved his way to OSU, where his football success took a detour.
You know, I brought a bad cloud, dark cloud on Oklahoma State, you know, and I feel bad for that. And that's why I feel like I need to speak on this, because they're trying to put just the first part out of it, but tell the whole story.
Sports Illustrated opened its drug report with Bowling's darkest moment. In February 2009, police arrested the receiver for possession of marijuana and paraphernalia. One of many players, the report claims, was part of a widespread drug culture.
Was there a lot of drug use back when you were on the team?
I'd never seen no drug use. You know, like I said, I made my own mistakes.
Bowling says the magazine used court records to document his punishment and subsequent team suspension in 2009, but that's where it stopped.
Did Sports Illustrated ever talk to you?
Never. Never talked to me, never spoke to me, and didn't know anything about it.
The report says Bowling got back on the team in 2010 after counseling. What's not listed are weekly drug tests and a player contract that, if broken, meant instant dismissal.
Hey, these are all allegations. Now everyone's painting that to be true. Well, let's let the NCAA and everyone investigate it and then find out the truth, instead of everyone just talking about it and spreading more rumors.
Bowling says he left OSU to play for the Canadian Football League, and coming up tonight at 6, he'll share more on this suspected drug culture that existed here at OSU. Live in Stillwater, Morgan Chesky, KOCO 5 News.
Okay, Morgan, now the series is not over. Tomorrow, Sports Illustrated will release its fourth section called The Sex. The authors say hostesses had sex with recruits while on visits.